I'm Connor Johnston. I'm a freshman here at Southeastern. I'll be studying digital journalism. I'm from Fort Myers, Florida. I've lived there all of 19 years of my life now. It's actually like living in Lakeland for the first time, really not living in Fort Myers. One of my favorite things growing up, or memories, it still is today, is every like November we'll go to Michigan, me and my dad and my brother, and we'll see my cousins and everyone, and we go whitetail deer hunt. And so you can't tell there, but usually it's snowing and it's cold and you sit in a blind, but like it's just in the woods and you're by yourself and you got a lot of time to just like think. It's really, I enjoy it a lot. Something I'm good at and also enjoy is mountain biking. So out my home in Fort Myers, there's a small town called Alva, and there's a track there called the Coosahatchee Regional Park. And it's about 13 miles, and my uncle actually introduced me to it. He cycled, like raced on the road in a mountain bike. And it's something I've always loved. It's just, I don't know, it's hard, but I really enjoy it. Something I want to get better at is listening. I'm always still better than a good listener. I guess you're trying to tell me something about zoning around or whatnot. So I would like to be better at that. I think that's really important, is that people understand, like, feel like when they're talking to you, that they're understanding of them. Goal in life. I would really like to live out west. That's the Rocky Mountains. I got to go out to the Rocky Mountains about 2 years ago, and it was unbelievable. It was life-changing seeing those mountains and stuff. And not only just live out there, but I've always kind of, I did an internship with my church, and so ministry has always kind of been something I feel like I'm called to do. And when I was out there, like, when you see mountains like that and you're kind of like outside, it puts a lot of things in perspective to me. And so I would like to maybe open like a camp or like a ranch and have kids that have not had the best lives be able to come out into the mountains and just see it and kind of put perspective how big life is and that there's possibilities. And I think mountains do that. They can put things like that in perspective. Another goal in my life is to finish an Ironman race. So an Ironman race is like it's a triathlon. And my entire family, I've had people that have been like really good at endurance competition. So one of my cousins in Grayling, in Michigan, where we're from, it's not that picture, but he is one of the best canoers in the world. It's like 24 hours, and they get in a canoe and they go down the Salo River, and all through night, like, they don't get out of the boat, and they just, it's crazy. But the race in the Salo River is like one of the big major races, and he holds the record for that. And again, my uncle, who introduced me to riding bikes, has ridden bikes his whole life. So like, something that I've always been into is endurance races, and that's like one of the hardest ones. So I'd love to compete in an Ironman race. Three words on my funeral is endurance, but not in the aspect of like endurance racing. I think in our culture, a lot of people literally start their life out strong, and then they start to fade and forget kind of who they are later in life. And so I want to be remembered as someone that always stood to who I was and had endurance throughout my life and stuck to what I believed. Understanding. So I talked about being able to listen. I want people to look at me as someone that was able to look at their situation, understood where they came from, and didn't judge, but helped people and could just really understand who they are. And then the third word is provider. So my dad and my mom have always worked really hard to provide and give me a life that I was pretty comfortable. So I want to be able to do that, not just for my kids, but for everyone around me. I want to be able to